Hey, what's up everyone? So today I'm going to talk about the state of the real estate market in Las Vegas and kind of give you guys some information. Yes, I'm wearing a Padres hat. Go Padres. I don't know how you screwed it up this year, all that talent, but that's a video for another day. Today we're going to talk about where Vegas is in real estate, how everything is going on. So I do everything in real estate. I don't pigeon myself into one thing or another. I do everything from normal real estate to luxury to land to industrial, multifamily, commercial developments, you name it, I've actually done it. I didn't just take some CE course and sat in a class and just sit there and listen and then said, I'm an expert and I have a certificate. No, I've done it all, everything you can imagine, right? So let me explain to you where we are. It's October 16th. I can't believe it. Felt like yesterday was October 1st, October 15th, right? So interest rates are in the 8% range, between high sevens, low eights. You'll probably buy down your rate to low sevens, high sixes. Everybody's freaking out. To be honest with you, I have listings that I've listed and I've listed them for good prices, maybe 5% under where the market is or was, however you wanna see that. And I'm not getting any calls. And I'm doing the same marketing. I'm putting a lot of effort behind it. Ads, social media, videos, photographers. I'm actually not doing the same marketing. I'm doing more because they're just sitting. Nobody's buying right now, at least under $1 million, which is nuts. So let me give you the flip side of this. From my understanding, August of 2023 in Las Vegas, there were the most luxury sales in the history of Las Vegas. So how does that make sense that everything under $1 million is pretty much just stopped, right? Not to say that there's not real estate sales and things aren't going into contract. I did put 3 or 4 into contracts in the past 2 weeks, but that's not normal for me. Normally I do a lot more, but it's what's not normal is to not get any activity on houses that are priced right. And I'm talking about 500, 600, high $400,000 houses. Usually I would get calls all day long, showings, multiple offers. It is dead. It is crickets, right? So what does that mean? That means you got to get creative. That means you got to get with your sellers and you got to tell them, hey, you need to start giving closing costs. You need to give closing costs and you need to buy down the buyer's rate, right? Because that's the biggest concern, is the buyer's rate, right? So buyers have a high sevens, low eight interest rates. You're gonna have to spend an additional $3,000 to $5,000 just to buy down the buyer's interest rate. That's gonna make them feel more comfortable. They're gonna have a lower rate. It's gonna make them wanna move forward. And that's how you gotta get your property sold, right? Open houses, I've never had luck with open houses, unless it's a luxury property, totally different thing. But let's just talk about the average house, right? Let's just focus on the average house. Open houses, they don't do anything. The only thing open houses are good for under $1 million is for some new agent to sit in there, to hopefully buyers walk in that aren't represented. You have a good rapport with them and you're able to retain them as clients. That's it, right? I don't care what people say. I've been doing this 20 years. I'm one of the top agents. Don't do open houses under $1 million. It's a waste of time. What are the odds of somebody just walking in off the street and saying, I love it. I've been looking for this exact house forever and here I am and God just led me to this house. Not that God isn't great, but that rarely happens, right? So you have to really get creative. You have to really think outside the box. That is where the market is today in Las Vegas. I'm also licensed in San Diego, trying to get more of a foothold there, but from my understanding, it's still low inventory out there as well. But interest rates just basically price everyone out. Unless you're cash, you're priced out. You can't afford it. You just can't. Your debt to income ratios do not allow you to go that high, right? If you were qualified for, you know, a $500,000 house, and rates were at 5.5%, now they're 8%, you just went down to a $300,000 house, 3.25%, right? So the market has to readjust and start dropping, and that's why the recession has been what it is, right? It's pretty much putting a halt. I got off the phone with a title company actually on Friday, and she told me that they've had 7 layoffs in in the past 45 days. And I think there's one or two title companies that are actually going out of business because it's just so dead, like super dead, right? So agents out there, get creative, you know? Think outside the box. Don't do what everybody's doing. Don't do the Mike Ferry, Tom Ferry, John Ferry, whatever Ferry, you know, script, because everybody's doing the exact same thing, right? You better get out there. You better start talking to people in the gym. You better start talking to people at the grocery store. You better start talking to people at the gas station, and you better make your sphere of influence bigger. Because if you don't have enough business, you're not talking to enough people. That's what I was taught. It's a really good mantra to live by, especially when you're in real estate. So I hope this helps you guys. I really, really do. And don't just sit back and just do, well, I'm doing everything that I thought I should be doing. You better be doing something more. You better figure it out, right? Because your clients are relying on you to get that house sold or that land or that commercial or that multifamily or whatever it is. So figure it out.